is a 316 L-grade. It's a stretch bolt.
We chose this sample deliberately. Testing small diameter materials with LIBS or SPARK OES is difficult for two reasons. They're harder to grind uniformly and harder to make a flush contact on the curved surface. With Z, you can test several times in the same spot. For small diameter parts, carbon readings will stabilize after 2 to 3 burns, and you'll get repeatable values, even for L grades.
Right, so stretch it to a piece because of the narrow diameter, about 1/4 inch. So this is a good one to, we might have to test this a few times just because it's harder to get it, the laser flush to that surface. You can see how that looks. There's our pre-burn. It's a good quiet pre-burn. If I could hold it still for once. Oh, hey, could you scroll down a little bit? Thanks. So maybe it just took a longer pre-burn. After a couple of, it took a couple of shots to really burn things off, but now the carbon chemistry is really, really pretty tight. 020, 019, 017, keep testing here. So maybe we just didn't clean it real well, but once we burned off the material, it was 4 good solid tests in a row, 190, 170, 220, 200, and we can keep going.
Yeah, there's a variant. Sometimes they do one burn, sometimes they do two burns for pre-burn.
Yeah, but check out that. That's really, really, really good repeatability on L grade. All right, once we kind of burned everything off, we moved over here. Look, 020, 019, 017, 022, 021.
That's really good. That's really
so
good.
If I'm an operator, I'm going to just say, look, I was burning carbon off here, these guys, and maybe this one too. I pull them out of the average. Oops. And then you have to scroll over those last 5 tests. Average 020.
Last
deviation 10-20 ppm. So there you go. This is your 316L.
Done. Excellent. All right.